Hey, Peter here from my FSHD. So I get a lot of questions about what do my methylation numbers mean? You get your report back, it tells you FSHD1, FSHD2, healthy, not FSHD, but there's a lot of other information in there, quartiles, ranges of methylation, and such. So today I'm going to dig into that really quick, make sure that everyone understands all of their own data. Okay, so you will remember that FSHD is an epigenetic disease. What that means is the DUX4 gene, which is the same sequence in someone who is healthy or someone with FSHD, is under differential epigenetic regulation. Okay, in healthy individuals, the DUX4 gene is epigenetically off, and this is signaled by very heavy DNA methylation, whereas in FSHD, the situation is reversed. It's lost the signal for repression, and the DUX4 gene is now epigenetically on. There is no DNA methylation or very little DNA methylation, and you end up getting pathogenic DUX4 gene expression in skeletal muscle. Okay, but it's not completely binary like that. So there, you can have different levels of DNA methylation. Okay, you can be very heavily methylated in the healthy state. You can actually lose quite a bit of methylation and still be essentially epigenetically silenced. All the way down to, well, truthfully, zero methylation, no methylation, okay, but everything in between. And we have seen as a general trend in the samples that we've done that lower levels of methylation tend to correlate with an earlier disease onset and more severe FSHD, whereas more methylation tends to correlate with being less severe, more mild, okay, but these are trends. There are always exceptions where some people with very low methylation might be mild or asymptomatic, and some people with higher methylation might be more severe. We don't fully understand this, and that's one of the reasons we're doing this study for the research to better understand epigenetic regulation FSHD. Okay, but let's go to the reports. That's why we're here. All right, so this individual is 4A, 4B haplotype, so they have a single FSHD permissive chromosome that we're going to assay, and we did our methylation analysis, and we found that they have 22.1% in the relative relevant quartile, which is Q2, but also you see that there's this range of methylation, the 0 to 42.8%, and then these different quartiles. Okay, and this is where the confusion seems to come in, so I'm going to explain that. So when we get a saliva sample from you, we actually get DNA from thousands and thousands of cells, okay? And all of these cells have the same genetics at the FSHD locus, but they have very different epigenetics, okay? So we get essentially one DNA sequence, but thousands of epigenetic sequences, okay? So here's the region we're assaying, the very distal part of chromosome 4q35, where the pathogenic DUX4 gene is located. Okay, and this is about 90 bases of DNA that we're looking at here, just as an example. And within here, you have 8 sites that can be methylated. And these are these boxes, and they can be red, that means they're methylated, or blue when they're unmethylated. And this is just 24 randomly selected chromosomes that we picked. And so here we go, we get this one down here, has 0 out of 8 methylation sites. And so, you know, it's 0% methylation. This one up here, number 24, has 5 out of 8 sites are methylated, so it's at like 62-63% methylation, and so that's your range, 0 to 62.5% methylation. Okay, and so you are, even though you're genetically pretty much the same at the FSHD locus within the cells in your body, epigenetically you have great variability, right? You can have some that are epigenetically on and some that are epigenetically off. Okay, so let's look at an actual couple of individuals. Okay, this is individual on the left here. We actually look at 100 chromosomes when we do this. Out of the thousands of reads, we randomly select 100. And you can see that this individual on the left has very low levels of methylation, FSHD levels there. Their Q2 is 24%, so that's in the FSHD range. But you can see there's a lot of epigenetically on chromosomes. And the individual on the right, healthy, you see a lot of red. You know, most of these are epigenetically off. Now the interesting thing is, you know, the individual with FSHD here on the left, you know, you can see there's actually a lot of cells, you know, are in the, you know, methylated would be the repressed state. So, you know, this individual is a mixture of epigenetically on and potentially pathogenic gene expressing cells versus epigenetically off and repressed cells. So you are a mixture, an epigenetic mixture, even though all your cells have the same genetics. So let's look at two people with FSHD, okay? They're both AB, and what do you know, they both have the same RQ, okay, 24%. Now, I know you guys are out there at home. You get your reports back, and you're comparing online and such. You know, what are your methylation numbers? And you're saying, but we're different. So are these people with the same methylation value, are they epigenetically the same? And the answer is no. You can see the individual on the right has a first quartile of 4%, and the individual on the left has a first quartile of 12%. Okay, so you can see that this individual has a lot more of the kind of the epigenetic dysregulation than the individual on the left, which may not be, realized by the number. This quartile number, the relevant quartile that we use, is really just for diagnostics, FSHD, yes or no. But there's a lot more information in here, and you can see the mixture, the epigenetic mixture of these two individuals is actually quite different. Okay, and so that's essentially what you are. You're a complicated person. You're a complicated mixture, epigenetically, and everybody's a little bit different. And so we're trying to get our handle on this, and that's the research component of the study that we're doing. So I hope you understood all that. It's all very clear. If not, feel free to drop me an email, give me a call. We can set up a Zoom meeting. I'm always happy to go over everybody's report and make sure everybody understands everything about their FSHD because, an educated population is really important for advocating for FSHD and FSHD therapeutics and diagnostics. So thanks. Bye.